Bravo.
Hello. Hello, hello, hello. Hi there. Welcome to the show. Barbara Major here, ready for our first night of the great 1989 Student Championship, the third in a series. It's about time we got some young blood around the place, isn't it? What do you reckon? This will be great. Nice audience too. Hello, everyone.
Hi.
Good to see you. Thanks for coming. Ladies and gentlemen, to help me conduct matters this evening and to talk about how we're going to do all this and everything, would you please welcome our French mistress, Elise Platt. You can be French mistress.
Oh, I'd like to be. Hello. Hey. Hello. Hello.
Well,
hi.
As I said, Elise.
Yes.
This is the third in a series. Approximately 30 schools from each state were randomly selected and asked to put forward their best 3 Year 12 students for audition.
Our production team then went around Australia and conducted strenuous auditions.
Including free Grundy lunches at all the different bistros.
And out of those auditions we have our finest of, how many is it, 12?
It's the cream of Australia's youth. Ready, 6 seats, 2 semi-finals, and then the best of 10 for the final series. It'll be a fantastic month, won't it, dear?
It will be very, 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 very good.
Have you got the first 3 victims there
bright
for me?
Bright kids. Yes, I have. Our first contestant is a student at Nudgee College from Castledean, Queensland. Please welcome Lawrence Muir. And our second contestant is a Year 12 student at Seymour College, Adelaide, from South Australia. Let's welcome Mirren Waters. There's only 2 girls, actually. And our third contestant studies at Geelong Grammar School from Geelong, Victoria. Please welcome Justin Christensen.
Justin, great to see you. Got a soft spot for Geelong because my nephews went to Geelong Grammar, as
no
a matter of fact.
There.
Hey?
No longer
Well,
there,
one of them's left and gone to Beckton and they're all over the place. Justin, you're in the cricket team?
Not this year. I've done my back out like Bruce Reid and it's not too good.
That's no good. No.
I read that you were best and worst on the cricket ground, is that
Well, right? I got a hat trick one day, which I was really proud of doing that, but unfortunately 2 ducks when I batted, so up and down.
You have days like that. Yeah. Good luck in the game, Justin.
Thanks, Tony.
Geelong Grammar's right behind you. Seymour College, Marin. What is that, a private school?
Or? Yes.
What sort of, is it a denominational?
It's Uniting Church.
Uniting Church,
yeah.
Right. And how's Year 12 going for you?
All right.
What are they calling it now in Adelaide? Is it now here? It's VCE in Victoria. What is it there?
It's matriculation or Year 12.
Just old matric, eh? Good luck to you. And Lawrence from Queensland. When we were at the Naval College, some of the brightest guys came from Nudgee College.
Did they?
Yeah, it's a top school, isn't it, Lawrence?
Yeah, it is.
Very good. What are your sporting things?
I like chess, skateboarding.
Chess, skateboarding. What do they call it when you're in the skateboarding team? The first 4 wheels or something?
No, it's not a team, just something you do.
Yeah, just on the hobby side of things. It's good to have you all here. Good luck, any one of you through to
have
the semis.
Have a good game, everyone.
Terrific.
And I'll see you
Isn't
soon.
Isn't it nice to have all this young blood around?
Great.
Yeah, $20 with which to begin. The idea is to accrue the most money, of course, over the 3 rounds. 4? Yeah. In 1987, which Australian won the Wimbledon men's singles, Lawrence?
Pat Cash.
It was, yes. What is the one-word term for a female ballet dancer, Lawrence?
Ballerina.
Yes, Queensland's very quick. What number Jump Street features in the title, Mirren?
21.
21 Jump Street, right? You like that? Johnny Depp? This means you listen carefully. What piece of jewellery is mentioned in the lyrics of this song?
I got flowers.
Justin.
Ring.
Yes, I thought, very close. Give you the benefit of the doubt, you're getting it. Justin, right. Well done, you're off the mark. From I Got You, Babe, by UB40. In terms of population, the largest state in Australia is New South Wales. Justin.
Yes.
You think we were going to say, is this true?
No
we were
going to
say,
didn't.
Which state ranks second? It's Victoria. Lost that hard-gotten $5. What word means both to talk in a joking way and a young goat? Justin.
Oh. No.
Kid. kid around. Lawrence knew too slow. Doesn't matter. Gift shop time. Lawrence, you're leading by $5 from Maroon, $30 to spend, and we'd like to take you to the gift shop.
And Lawrence, it'll be to your advantage to take a swing at this Ceramic Destiny graphite tennis racket. It's got a wide contour frame with huge sweet spot for added power, round sharp construction to reduce vibration, and anatomical grip design. Normally $287, tonight $6 from Pro Kennex Australia and Sale of the Century, and Michelle pruned you.
Brondon.
Brondon.
Michelle Brondon.
Yep. Sorry.
Good to hear from you, Michelle.
Thanks.
Can I have a go at that?
Yep.
You're the Bacchus... Don't I get a go? You're the Bacchus Mask... Gilmore Open. Epping Open and Hawthorne under 18s for this year, right?
Yep.
That's terrific. Are you going to... She's a very accomplished young tennis player. So you reckon this is really good gear, Michelle?
Yeah.
Terrific.
You're going to buy it, Lawrence? I mean, you look terrific in that skirt. I can really see you.
No.
No. Not even for $4. Oh, sold at that price. You got him. Well done. Okay. Took a bit of doing. A violin has four strings. How many strings has a viola? Justin.
Six.
Four. Just like the violin. In which ocean is the kingdom of Tonga? Lawrence.
Pacific.
It is. In the Pacific, the Friendly Isles. What form of percussion instrument is the tom-tom? Lawrence. The beat of the tom-tom. And it'd have to be a drum, wouldn't it? Be a drum. Who am I? I was born in England in the mid-1960s, and as a boy, I was brought up in Lancashire. In the early 1980s, I did odd jobs around the studio of producers Mike Stock, Peter Waterman, and Mike Aitken. Lawrence.
Rick Astley.
I am Rick Astley. You're right. My mum just loves Rick Astley, and he's a very popular boy indeed. On the board for you to pick from, these faces.
Richard Wilkins.
Richard Wilkins from MTV.
Rebecca Gibney.
The Flying Doctors.
Angry Anderson.
Midday Show with Ray Martin.
Deacon Blue.
Deacon Blue's a good mob.
Melissa Cocoluto.
Let's have a big hand for our home viewer. She's a lovely girl there.
Tammy McIntosh.
Come on, kids.
Daryl Braithwaite.
What a comeback. He is number one with that big album of his.
Lisa Bonet.
The Cosby Show.
Ernie Sigley.
In Melbourne today. Yes, Lawrence.
I'll have Ernie Sigley.
Ernie Sigley coming up.
Congratulations, you won a package of ladies and men's tennis and leisure clothing, including tracksuits, shorts and more, valued at $600 from Charade Designs.
Well done. You're going to get that tennis gear one way or another. There it is, end of round one. We're playing the student championship for 1989. Back with round two right after the break. Don't go away.
Tonight, 7:30, the Refrigerator Raiders strike once too often.
No. We've come for food.
Cosby is hilarious. Tonight, 7:30 on 9.
Just for the cool of it. Coca-Cola, just for the kick, the beat, the zing, the taste. Diet Coca-Cola, only one calorie with a real cola taste. Just for the taste of it, Diet Coke.
Eddie Films presents a primetime TV quiz show. Now, Iggy, here's your final question. Yeah. Which carpet retailer makes the offer of free underlay with the purchase of 20 metres or more of their heavily discounted carpet?
Oh, I know that. Iggy Thompson.
Amazing! Free underlay with the purchase of 20 metres or more of any carpet in stock. Eddie Thompson's carpet land at Salisbury, Chermside, Miami Gold Coast, and now at Underwood. Eddie Thompson.
Copper Art has surplus stock, which must be liquidated. Ficus and Magnolia trees, now down to $19.95. Chalice planters, look, two for $10. Black cats, liquidated at $10 a pair. Giant watches, $10. Hurry while stocks last.
There are many ways to take the chill out of a winter's night, but there's only one this delicious. Self-sourcing sponge puddings from White Wings. This one is butterscotch.
Nobody does it better. Makes me feel sad for the rest.
property you're buying or selling, talk to L.J. Hooker. Nobody does it better. L.J.
Thank
Hooker,
you, Mr. Hooker.
Give a whistle. Round two, night one of the student championships, and let's hoe into it. By the way, there's no cash card tonight. Extra questions to test these brilliant young brains, all right? Starting with B, what is a written account of a person's life? Justin.
Biography.
It is. From which ancient mythology is the story of Oedipus, Lawrence?
Greek.
From the Greek, yes, Oedipus. For most of the human race, which natural product ceased to be the sole sweetening agent in the human diet? Lawrence.
Sugar?
Oh, no. Some people are actually still using that. This is honey. It was the main sweeteners up until a couple hundred years ago. Honey. The Latin term for travelling with a concealed identity is... Justin.
Incognito.
Incognito. Pluribus, monibus, etc. You're not doing Latin for your...
No.
PC? No, good. What is my name? My name? I am a creature with many varieties to be found throughout the world, inhabiting steamy jungles near the equator. I've been found on Arctic ice caps. My smallest have wingspreads of about 3 millimetres, while my big ones, the giant owl of South America, for instance, have a wingspread of about 30 millimetres. Although destructive of clothing, my best-known benefit to humans is the production of silk, closely related to butterflies, with whom? Lawrence.
A moth.
I'm a moth. I'm a moth. That's what I am, a moth. Have a pick, Lawrence, and good luck. Leading the way at the moment.
Angry Anderson.
Angry Anderson, right.
Congratulations, Lawrence. You won a Stoneware Australian Heritage Village, valued at $554 from Heritage Giftware.
Oh, that's all right, isn't it? Yeah, nice one. Well done, Lawrence. In which sport is throwing in the towel literally Mirren?
Boxing.
In boxing, a symbol of defeat. You're right, Mirren. Not counting on you, by the way, Mirren. With all the auditioning and everything that was done, sadly, I must relate, there are only two young ladies represented in this whole contest, one of which you are. I'm Just Wild About Harry was the campaign song for which US president, Justin?
Harry Truman.
1948. Harry S. Truman is correct. Which continent is the western part of the Eurasian landmass? Lawrence.
Europe.
It is. Europe. Correct. Well done. What is both a room set apart for small children and babies? Mirren.
Nursery.
And a place where plants are raised and you've done well. First edition Fast Money, 30 seconds on the clock. Gang, let's go for this now. Your time starts now. From which modern language do we get the word entrepreneur? Justin.
French.
Yes, a fussy, stuffy person is sometimes called a fuddy. Mirren.
Daddy.
Correct. In which continent is the Serengeti Game Reserve? Lawrence.
Africa.
Correct. Add a two-letter prefix and what is the antonym of direct? Lawrence.
Indirect.
Correct. In which country was actor Omar Sharif born? Justin.
Egypt.
Yes, who sang the popular Like a Prayer? Justin.
Madonna.
Correct. In James Barry's Peter Pan, the pirate captain was? Lawrence.
Captain Hook.
Yes, colloquially, Kiwiland means? Lawrence.
New Zealand.
Yes, you're very good, Doc. Very good. All played well then. Lawrence kept his advantage. Leading by 11, Lawrence got a chance to spend some of that ill-gotten gain. Now, right, I don't know if you're musical or not, but Elisa's about to find out.
Well, do yourself a favour, Lawrence, and invest in a beautiful pro-quality electronic keyboard. It reproduces the sounds of dozens of instruments, has built-in rhythm, stand and starter kit, and it's normally $530, but tonight, $9 will be music to your ears from Allen's and Sailor's Entry and our special guest keyboard player, John Thorne, from Miss Dorothy and his Fools in Love.
Good stuff. John, thanks for coming and being with us. By the way, Miss Dorothy and This Fool's in Love, that group played the...
That's
what I said.
Yeah.
So Miss Dorothy and His Fool's in Love. They're playing at the Royal Derby. Royal Derby Hotel on Saturday nights now nights, and it's good. Lawrence, what about it? The keyboard.
No.
For you. I was going to say $7.
I've got one.
You've got $1, but I'm offering it to you for $7. So, all right, no deal. The island country of Madagascar became... This is not for you, by the way. Island country of Madagascar became independent on this day, 1960, having been a colony of which European power since 1896? We'll be back to tell you the answer to that.
Each year, the world's most prestigious championship attracts over 600 competitors. Their eyes on centre court, determined to win.
He's missed it! It's all over!
Many will fall. Over 2 weeks, egos will be shattered. A
expectations destroyed.
Oh, that's an unbelievable shot.
As it comes down to the world's best, starting tonight, following the second test, the one event that stands alone. Wimbledon 1989, live and exclusive to Nine's Wide World of Sports.
Of this company's on the line. I want all the figures. Jensen?
Yes, Sir Robert. I have here the complete fiscal records of the last five financial years and the figures year to date. These are all major related subsidiary companies going to overseas investments. Yeah!
$1?
Yourself an instant scratch it.
Westfield's where the best stores are, and Westfield's everywhere.
You don't have to go all over Brisbane to find the big sales, because all the big sales are at Westfield shopping towns. Fashion sales, footwear, food sales, electrical, leisure gear, heaps of hardware. Everyone's on sale at Westfield until July 1st, all under one roof at your Westfield shopping town.
Have a good day. Shopping.
Bowl.
Dole.
No, bowl.
Zeta.
Dole.
Thank you.
His English hasn't improved.
Nuts.
Nubs.
Very good. Planter's nuts. Very delicious.
Planker's nubs. Very nudicious.
Excellent.
Planker's nubs. Very nudicious.
I hate it when he does that.
All right, it's round three. Remember, no cash cards. Incidentally, what I haven't mentioned is that these young people over the period of 4 weeks are playing for really great prizes. A trip around the world, including Japan first, and a language course, $20,000 to better further their education, a four-wheel drive for the whole family, and a computer for their school. The answer to the home viewers' questions is France. Madagascar used to belong to France. Now, players, what colour shells have the eggs of the Leghorn breed of poultry? Lawrence.
Brown.
White. White Leghorns, white eggs. Of what organ of the body is eczema a disorder? Lawrence.
The skin.
Skin, yes. Nations around which sea grow most of the world's olives? Lawrence.
Mediterranean.
Around the Mediterranean. He's got that edge in speed so far, the Queenslander. What is my name? Pick of the board. I'm the title of a person who carries responsibilities for administration, normally elected to the position in places such as Australia and Britain. I'm largely honorary, apart from certain allowances and expenses. In the USA, I'm usually a paid position. In Australia, I'm head or chairman of a local government area and supervise paid officials. Lawrence.
Ombudsman.
Nope. In the cities, I'm sometimes prefixed with the title Lord. Mirren.
Mayor.
Mayor. Mayor is right. Gives you a chance to catch up. Okay. There's three lots of play money up there, which will help a lot if you get in.
I'll have Lisa Bonet, please.
Lisa Bonet.
Take it easy, Mirren. You've won a home therapy spa, which fits all bars and relieves backache and tension, valued at $1,375 from Alpha Therapy Home Spas.
Very handy. Just fits terrifically in, just into your bath at home. You know, it's really good. Which country launched the first nuclear-powered merchant ship? Lawrence.
United States.
In 1959, USA is correct, the Savannah. What heavenly bodies have a solid centre, a round head? Justin.
Planets.
And a long tail. They are comets. Back to 35, Justin. Listen carefully. Which numbered floor is mentioned in the lyrics of this song?
My name is Luca.
Mirren.
Second.
Second floor, Luca by Susan Vega. Mirren goes to 45, yes. The New Zealand Parliament meets in which city? Justin.
Auckland.
Wellington is the capital of New Zealand.
Wellington. Still widely regarded as the greatest single contribution ever made to science is the Principia by Sir Isaac Newton. 1987 marked the how many hundred years anniversary of its publication? Mirren.
200?
300, sorry, back to 40. Which film about the Vietnam War won the Academy Award? Lawrence.
Platoon.
Best Picture, 1987, Platoon. Lawrence, you've been very steady, and it's showing in the scores. A Study in Scarlet marked the debut of Master Justin.
Sherlock Holmes.
Detective Sherlock Holmes, who was his creator, Conan Doyle. Sometimes it pays to wait. Doesn't matter, though. This is the final pick of the board. Who am I? I was born in Germany in the early 1800s, studying at the universities of Göttingen, Paris, Berlin and Vienna. Justin.
Karl Marx.
Incorrect. I became professor of chemistry at the University of Heidelberg. I was famous as a great teacher, but I'm also known as an inventor of several types of cells and apparatus used in experiments on the properties of gases. My best-known invention, which bears my surname, is a gas burner, providing an intensely mirren.
Bunsen?
Yeah, Robert Bunsen was his name. Bobby Bunsen. Do you, you're doing science, Mirren?
Yes, physics.
Physics, well, that helps, doesn't it? Which face would you like?
I have Richard Wilkins' place.
Good luck with the money. You've got... helps. Right, only $11 of difference in front. Where's the other money?
Joe Braithwaite had the wild card. The other money was with Rebecca Gibney in the home viewer, and Tammy McIntosh had the 25.
Okay, so, well... bit hard for you now, Justin, because there's only 30 seconds left in the game. Lawrence and Maroon are going to have a real battle. We'll be back after this break to wrap it up. To finish it off.
A hilarious... In even the cleanest house, bacteria breed. Luckily, there's a sensitive instrument that tells us where. It's called... the human nose. You see, bacteria cause most household smells, smells air fresheners only cover up. But disinfectant Glen 20 kills bacteria, and that kills smells for good. So trust your nose and Glen 20. Glen 20 kills the bacteria that cause the smells.
Last little bit, everyone. 30 seconds of the first heat. Remember, one heat winner through to the semi-final. Tonight, we've got Victoria, South Australia and Queensland. There will be representatives, two more representatives from each state, of course, as the series progresses. Let's see who bowls this one over. 30 seconds on the clock, please. Good luck, guys. Your time starts... and girl. Time starts. Now, a hexad is a group of how many years? Justin.
Six.
Yes, what kind of creature is a noisy pitter? Lawrence.
A bird.
Yes, what starting with Y is added to dough to make it rise? Justin.
Yeast.
Yes, to which country would one go to see the Great Sphinx? Lawrence.
Egypt.
Yes, who was the official propagandist of Nazi Germany? Lawrence.
Joseph Goebbels.
Correct. What beverage featured at a Boston party? Lawrence.
Tea.
Yes, which great American died at Mount Vernon? Lawrence.
George Washington.
Yes, on what continent is the platypus a native? Lawrence.
Australia.
Yes, he's got that hammering it down to his speed. Lawrence Muir from Nudgee College. Big win for Queensland tonight. Well done, Lawrence. That was excellent. Mirren and Justin, you knew all them, didn't you? Just that,
oh, sure. Yeah.
Just the difference in speed. It's been terrific to have you here, and Elise would like to tell you some
I'd
things.
Like to say thank you very much for playing, Justin. And Mirren, you're going home with prizes to the total of $1,375. Congratulations. That was
thank
great.
You.
And both of you will receive the electronic sailor's entry board game from Crown and Andrews, plus our champagne diamond set stick pin from Bruce and Moss Jewellers. Bye-bye.
And in addition to that, Peter has something special for you too.
Justin and Mirren will each receive this Wordmaster electronic thesaurus with dot matrix screen and 83,000 word vocabulary. Valued at $199 from the Franklin Computer Corporation and sale of the century.
Well done, Lawrence.
Thanks.
You like role playing?
Role playing, yeah.
It says on the list, role playing. Now you can play the role of the sale of the century winner. For a moment. And you did it very well. Let's go shopping. You've won something straight away. Just over here, Lawrence.
Oh, yo.
This side, mate. Would you just stand here for a second? And I'll show you what you've won for your great heat win this night.
audio technology to take you into the next century. This complete music center features a 15-step programmable compact disc player, double cassette with high-speed dubbing, 5-band graphic equalizer, turntable, tuner, and two-way speakers. Valued at $799 from Samsung and sale of the century.
It's great, isn't it? You got any brothers and sisters?
No.
That's good, because you won't have anyone to sort of mess it up. They're very sensitive things. Now, if you keep up this pace, you've got a bit of speed there on the buzzer. If you keep winning semi-finals, final, get through, here's one of the things you could win as student champion.
Get a taste of a different culture on this trip for two to Japan and Europe. First stop is exciting Tokyo. Then explore the local lifestyle for 2 weeks, courtesy of JAL Tour, with a comprehensive Japanese language course included. With $5,000 spending money and business class airfares, this journey of a lifetime is valued at $27,675 from Japan Airlines, Hilton International, and Westpac.
That'd be all right. Never been to Japan?
No, never.
Then it's on to Europe. And, of course, there's the $20,000 in your kick, which wouldn't go astray.
No.
Now, we don't like to leave the schools out because we've had their cooperation in the selection process, and should you be the successful player, your school will cop one of these.
The 1989 Student Champion School can extend its educational facilities with this Amiga 2000 computer. With double disc drive, the machine can run two operating systems and features color screens, superior graphics, and advanced audio performance. Valued at $6,990 from Commodore Computers and sale of the century.
And we thought it'd be good to have the whole family involved too. Quiet, me, Fifi, that's enough. We thought it'd be nice for the whole family, this one.
Presenting the new LS Holden Jackaroo, the most powerful four-wheel drive in its class. With a fuel-injected 2.6-litre engine coupled with 5-speed manual transmission, the four-door Jackaroo has pure go-anywhere power, combined with the driving luxury of power steering, cruise control, velour seats and trim, and 4-speaker stereo system. The new LS Jackaroo four-wheel drive is on the road at $35,547 from Holden, Australia's driving future.
Lawrence of Arabia. That's, I see those poodles love a Jackaroo, don't they? That's for the whole family, so that'd be a good prize if you went through. Did you enjoy it tonight?
Yes.
Great. Tomorrow night we have Tasmanian, a sand groper, and a Waratah. New South Wales represented tomorrow evening. We'll see you then. Keep smiling, and bye for now.
Good night.
Peace by the Queensland. Good night, Frankie.
This is a Grundy television production for the Nine Network. Peter Smith speaking.